Hello everyone, welcome back to Math Class of Class 9. We are doing mensuration. Before, in previous classes, we discussed about area of part of room, area of floor, area of parts, area of different geometrical figures. Now, in this class, we will be discussing about volume and cost estimation. What do you understand by volume? Volume is the space occupied by a solid object, such as any kind of like cartoon, ball, room, you, yes, bed, cupboard, whatever is around you that is covered, that covers certain space. That space is called volume, and it is measured in cubic unit, like meter cube, centimeter cube, yeah, and unit. If the a unit of a cube of side 1 cm, then 1 cm cube is its volume.
How to find the volume of object, regular object? Suppose it is a cuboid. Then what is the formula to calculate the volume of cuboid? As we know that volume is the product of area of base and height. Area of base into height. And area of base is L into B. If it is length, if it is breadth, then L into B into H is the formula to calculate the volume of cuboid. Similarly, if it is cube, then L cube, because all the values are same. And now in the case of room, then L into B into H you will do. Okay. Now suppose a wall is there, you have to find number of bricks. Then how can we find? First of all, you will find the volume of wall. Now next, volume of each brick also you have to find. L1 into B1 into H1, and then to find the number of bricks used in this wall. For that, volume of wall should be divided by volume of brick. Okay, volume of wall should be divided by volume of brick. Similarly, for the cost, like if cost of one brick is R and number of brick is n, then what will be the total cost? Number into rate. Next, here, if the wall contains a window of length, like wall is there, if the wall contains window then we have to remove that part. Okay, if the wall contains window or door, then we have to remove that part. If a wall contains a window of length L1 and height H1 and a door of length L2 and height H2. Suppose another door is also there, then volume of wall will be equals to L into B into H, length into breadth into height, minus we have to remove the volume of a window and volume of door. Now volume of window L1 into H1 and the breadth of the window. Okay, the breadth of this window is equals to the breadth of this wall. Breadth of this window is equal to the breadth of this wall. Always suppose here it is door. If we keep a door here, then whatever is the breadth of wall, that will be the breadth of window, breadth of door and breadth of wall will be same. So B, we use the same breadth, minus L2 H2 B for door also. Okay, actually the formula is L into B into H, L into B into H, L into B into H, but this for window different, for door different size we are using. But you have to know breadth of the door and breadth of the windows will not be given in question, but breadth of the wall is the equals to the wideness of the window. Suppose this is the wideness of window, here in middle it is a window, then length L1, height H1 and breadth is same. Here you're in the case of door also same, length L2, height maybe different, so L H2, but breadth is same. Okay, if liter is given, sometimes liter of that water tank also can be given. In that case we know that 1 meter cube equals to 1000 liter. Okay, 1 meter cube equals to 1000 liter. So 1 by 1000 meter cube equals to 1 liter. If 5000 liter is given, then divide by 1000, you will get 5 meter cube volume. If liter is given, you can find volume very easily. Just you have to divide by 1000. Okay. If the capacity of tank is 10,000 liter, then if 10 meter cube volume of that tank is 10 meter cube. So first question today, how many stones each of volume 600 cubic centimeter? Here we don't have to find the volume of stone, it is already given. Volume of stone is given 600 cubic centimeter. Will be required to construct the wall of the size is given there. Size of wall, that means length is 20 meter, breadth is, height is 10 meter, breadth is 30 centimeter. 20 meter into 10 meter into 30 centimeter. Now we have to find the number of stones. To find the number of stones, we have to divide volume of wall by volume of stone. You have to find volume of wall first. For that we will multiply this same, but it is given centimeter cube, so volume of wall also must be in centimeter cube, or if we find in meter cube, then we have to convert this also into meter cube. So I suggest you to convert this meter into centimeter first. This is already in centimeter, so only these two must be converted into centimeter. Size of wall is 20 meter into 10 meter into 30 centimeter. Now we can convert this meters into centimeter. So how can we convert meter into centimeter? Multiplying 100. Okay, so 20 meter means 2000 centimeter into 10 into 100, 1000 centimeter into, this is already in centimeter, no need to convert. Now let's multiply this 2000 into 1000 into 30. 2 1 2 3 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 centimeter cube. Now after getting this volume of stone is also there, let it be B2, and volume of wall is also here, let it be B1. You have to find number of stones. We have to find number of stone. What is the formula? Volume of wall divided by volume of stone. 6 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 centimeter cube divided by 600 centimeter cube. These two zero can be cancelled. The 6 1s are 6 1 2 3 4 5. Okay, number of stone is 1 lakh. If 24,000 bricks of the same size and the shape are required to build a wall, your number of brick is given. Number of bricks is given 24,000 of the same shape and size are required to build a wall of dimension this. So dimension of wall also given, means size of wall 15 meter into 6 meter into 20 centimeter. So let's convert into same unit, 2 are in meter, so let's convert this also in meter. 15 meter into 6 meter into, how can we convert into centimeter? 20 by 100, that is 0.2 meter. Okay, so that all are in meter, you can get volume of wall 15 into 6 into 0.2 meter. This is 18 meter cube. Okay, 18 meter cube. Now what do you have to find? You have to find volume of brick. You have to find volume of brick. How can we find? Let's use the formula of number. Number of brick equals to volume of wall divided by volume of brick. Number of wall is 24,000, volume of wall 18 divided by volume 2. Now it will be B2 is equals to 18 meter cube divided by 24,000. Now 18 divided by 24,000, how much? 18 divided by 24,000, 0.00075 meter cube. It is in meter cube. Now if you want in centimeter cube, now from meter cube to centimeter cube, how can we convert? 3 meters, so 3 times we have to multiply by 100, means 100 into 100 into 100, so that it will be in centimeter cube, 750 centimeter cube. Because meter cube, when we convert once, we have to multiply by 100, but here 3 times, so we have to multiply by 3 times. Okay, let's solve another question. Question number 5a. The internal dimension of lidless wooden box is 48 cm into 38 cm into 52 cm. Internal dimension is given 48 cm into 38 cm into 32 cm. Okay, 48, 38, 32. So internal volume will be 48 into 38 into 32. Now let's multiply this 48, 38. This 48, 38, and height is given 32. It will be 5,8,368 cm³. 58,368 cm³ is internal volume. Now let's find external dimension is if it is 48, then what will be the external part from year to year, where thickness is given 1 cm? So 48 plus 1 plus 1 50 cm, and breadth also it is given 38 inside, so plus 1 plus 1 plus 2 40. Into height is given your 32, but only down, only upper part there is no lid, so lidless is given, so only 1 cm will be added, 33 cm. Now let's multiply this 50 into 40 into 33, which will be 66,000 cm³. That is external volume is 66,000. Now you have to find the volume of wooden part, means this wood only we have to find. You have to find volume of wood, that is volume of external part minus volume of internal part. Let it be B1 and let it be B2. So B1 minus B2. 66,000 cm³ minus 58,368 cm³. Now let's subtract 58,368. 7,632 cm³ is the volume of this wooden part. Okay, internal parts dimension of internal part is given. Find the volume of internal part and external part also we have to find, and then subtract. Similarly, sometimes in question external part will be given. In that case, you can find the volume of external part by the given dimension, and volume of internal part also we have to find. For that, we have to subtract these parts, the thickness of the tank, and then you will get the internal dimension and internal volume you have to get. Same process we can do for that, okay? Number 6A. A water tank in the form of cuboid is 15 meter long. Length of tank is given 15 meter and 10 meter wide, means breadth of tank is 10 meter. We have to find depth of the tank, means height of the tank. You have to find height of tank h equals to what, where the capacity of tank is given 5 lakh liter. Capacity of tank is given 5 lakh liter. I already told you, if the capacity of tank is given, then can you find volume? How can we find volume of that tank? We know that 1 liter equals to 1 by 1000. No, yes. 1 liter equals to 1 by 1000 meter cube. So we have to divide by 1000. 5 lakh divided by 1000. When we divide by 1000, it will be meter cube. Now this side, you can use the formula of volume, which is L into B into H. Here three zeros. Three zeros can be cancelled. 500 meter cube is the volume. Length is given 15 meter. Breadth is given 10 meter. Depth, height is not given, which we are calculating. Now h is equals to 500 divided by 15 tens are 150 meter cube. This meter into meter, meter square. So height will be 3.33 meter. Therefore, the required depth of the tank is 3.33 meter. From given capacity, we can find the volume by dividing 1000 and then use the formula. Next question is here. Question number 7a. 3 cubes each of side 12 cm are joined. 3 cubes are there. Each side is 12 cm are joined and made a cuboid. Yes. So height is 12, breadth also will be 12, but length will be 12 plus 12 plus 12. Here length of cuboid is 12 plus 12 plus 12, 36 cm. Breadth of cuboid is 12 cm because length and base are same in the case of cube. Height of cuboid also same, 12 cm. Now you can find volume of cuboid. Volume of cuboid, that is L into B into H. 36 into 12 into 12. 36 into 12 into 12. 36 into 144. 5184. 5184 centimeter cube. And this question can be done in another way also. We could find the volume of one cuboid, a cube. So L cube multiply by 3. Or we could find the volume of cube at first, 12 into 12 into 12, and multiply by 3. 3 into 12 into 12 into 12 also is the correct solution. You can see next question there. The length of length, breadth and height of the cuboid are given 64, 32 and 16 cm respectively. We have to find the side of cube whose volume is equal to the volume of cuboid. Here length is given 64, breadth is given 32, height is given 16 centimeter. Now let's find the volume. Let's find the volume of cuboid. You can simplify by multiplying this length, breadth and height. 64 centimeter into 32 centimeter into 16 centimeter. 64 into 32 into 16. 32,768 centimeter cube. This is the volume of cuboid. Now it is given to find the side of cube whose volume is equal to the volume of cuboid. So volume of cuboid is equal to the volume of cube, new cube. Now what is the formula of volume of cube? We can write L cube is 32768. 32768. L is equals to, we can take cube root, 32768. Now what is cube root of this? 32 centimeter. Therefore, the side of cube is 32 centimeter.
Another question is there. Question number 9a. The measures of the cuboid are 9, 4 and 3. Means length, breadth and height are given there.
Length of cuboid 9 meter. Breadth of cuboid 4 meter and 3 meter is height. Height of cuboid is 3 meter.
Now how many boxes each measuring 40 centimeter, 30 centimeter and 10 centimeter can be kept? Now you have to find the volume of this cuboid and then volume of box also. First of all, let's find the volume of cuboid. Let it be b1. L into B into H, 9 into 4 into 3. Now let's multiply this. 108 meter cube is the volume of this cuboid. Now after getting the volume of this cuboid, inside of this cuboid we have to keep small boxes. Inside of this cuboid you have to keep small boxes. Okay, so that's volume is required. Same like that number of brick. Yes, same like that number of brick. Now volume of brick you will find.
Volume of your boxes is also L into B into H. And measuring 40 centimeter, 30 centimeter, 10 centimeter. 40 centimeter, 30 centimeter, 10 centimeter. But already we have got in meter cube, so we have to get this also into meter cube. So for that we will convert this all centimeters into meter.
How can we convert centimeters into meter?
Divide by 100. 40 by 100 is 0.4 meter, 0.3 meter, 0.1 meter.
We have to get the volume in meter, so meter cube. So we convert all into meter by dividing 100 into 0.3 into, let's multiply this.
We get 0.012 meter cube. Let it be B2. Now after getting the volume of small boxes, we can get number of box. Number of box is equals to volume of bigger cuboid divided by volume of box. 108 divided by 0.012.
108 divide
0.012 is 9000. It means 9000 such boxes can be kept inside of this cuboid. 9000 boxes can be kept inside the cuboid.